Everyone, are able to hear my voice? Are able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Today topic is open item management. Put the heading of open item management. Or opening balance management. Like that. Sunil, are you there?
Sir.
What is meant by open item management, if you have any idea?
No, sir.
Okay, anyone?
Opening balance.
See here. Before going to note it down, first listen. What is meant by open item management? Everyone, please catch the point. Open item management means it is monitoring the outstanding balance. Listen careful. In the non-SAP, we are called as a outstanding balance. In the SAP, we are called opening balance or open item balance. Got it my point? Once again, listen careful. In the non-SAP, we are called outstanding balance. In the SAP, we are called open item balance or open item management. Okay, concentrate. Open item management is monitoring receivable balance and payable balance. Open item management is monitoring receivable balance and payable balance. Open item management is clear the receivable balance and payable balance. Everyone, are you able to catch point? You just listen once again. What is meant by open item management? Open item management means it is monitoring the outstanding balances. It may be payable and it may be receivable. Okay, it may be payable and it may be receivable. Non-SAP we are called outstanding balance, but SAP we are called open item balance. Open item balance, same thing. It may be receivable balance, it may be payable balance. Okay, now note it down. Open item management. Once again. Note it down. If you set the open item management, indicator in master data records for an account. So here you need to catch the point. What is meant by open item management means at the time of GL creation, at the time of GL creation, there is a open item management indicator. Okay. Whenever you can create, accounts payable or how you people understand not accounts payable, it's a payable and receivable GLs. All the payables and receivable GLs. Do one thing. I will show you accounts group. Do one thing. See here. Tax. See this one. Tax receivable. Tax receivable is the payable. Okay. Tax receivable. And which unders even tax payable, and even sometimes it is an current liabilities, current assets, all the payable GLs and receivable GLs comes under open item management. Okay, all the payable GLs and receivable GLs comes under open item management. You everyone listen careful. Whatever GL comes under payable and receivable, okay, whatever GLs comes under payable and receivable, that GLs you need to activate open item management indicator at the time of GL creation. Okay, where you are in writing, John?
Yeah, it is all paid the payables and there's a change account.
Renuka, are you there?
You set open item management indicator master data repository for an account.
Okay, master data records. Note it down.
Yeah.
In the line items. The line items line items accounts is marked as a open or cleared. In the down you just write whichever GLs, next point you can write clearly, whichever GLs cleared in the future, whichever GLs cleared in the futures that GLs is called open item management. Example rent. You just understand this. I will showing one accounting entry. Everyone, you here you can understand the point. You just catch the point here. Rent account data to rent payable account. Example 10,000 and 10,000, and later. Later, rent payable account data to
bank account.
Cash account, cash or bank, cash. Very good. 10,000 and 10,000. So what need to, what is meant by open item management? You just concentrate. At the time of rent to payable GL creation, at the time of rent to payable GL creation, you need to activate open item management radio button or open item management indicator. Why? Because this rent to payable cleared in the future. For example, this is 01/04/2020, and example, this is 05/04/2020. When I post this accounting entry, the open item balance will show or outstanding balance will show, the rent payable 10,000. When I post this payment entry, that open item balance or outstanding balance will be cleared. Okay, so at the time of rent payable creation, you need to activate like open item management radio button. Okay, I will give you one more example. Example, commission receivable. Receivable account data to commission received. Commission receivable account data to commission received. Example, 20,000 and 20,000. And at the time of payment, what happened? Cash or
cash bank? Account return.
Very good. Cash or bank account data.
Commission received.
Commission received.
Yeah. Commission.
Clear.
Receivable. Commission receivable 20,000 and 20,000. See this one. Example, this is example 01/04/2020 and 05/04/2020. So what happened? See this one. When I post commission receivable. When I create commission receivable account data to commission received, and cash and bank account data to commission receivable. This commission receivable comes under debit year. This commission receivable comes under credit year. And debit credit goes to nullified. It's cleared in the future. Here, open item management here goes to cleared. And here also, rent payable credited here. Rent payable debited here. This is going to cleared. Okay. Whichever GL cleared in the future and whichever GL comes under balance sheet. Okay, there is a two rules need to accepted by the open item management. Open item management comes under balance sheet. Open item GL need to cleared in the future. For example, 1/4/2020 open item management and 5/4/2020 cleared. Why? Because here credit and here debit cleared, nullified, and here debit and here credit nullified. Okay, whichever GLs cleared in the future. And concentrate, all the payable GLs and all the receivable GLs, you must activate open item balance or open item management radio button. Let us see this transactions and post SAP and everyone. If I want to post rent account data to rent payable, first I need to create the GL. I need to create rent GL and I need to create rent payable GL. Okay, and see this one. If I I created some GLs like cash GL, Suresh Capital GL, salary GL, administration expenses GL, like this I created. Same way I need to create rent account data to rent payable. Okay, let's create the GLs. First, if you want to post accounting entry, first you need to create the GLs. Anyone, any doubts? What is meant by open item management?
No, sir. No doubt.
Very good.
No, sir.
Very simple. Open item management means it is monitoring the outstanding balance. Very simple. Okay. And whichever GLs comes under payable and receivable, that GLs you need to activate open item management radio button. Okay, now all the payable, tax payable, rent payable, and commission payable, all the receivable, tax receivable, commission receivable, rent receivable, all the receivable and all the payables comes under open item management. And open SAP. If you want to post open item, see everyone, if I want to post rent account data to rent payable, first I need to create the GL. What GL? Rent account data to rent payable GLs. Okay, I need to create rent GL and I need to create rent payable GL. And what is the T code for creating the GLs? It's still opening. So please wait some time, it's going on browse. Yeah. See this one. How to create the GL? Go to FS00. What is the T code? FS00. Then press enter. And first I need to create the rent GL. Rent GL, what is the number range for rent GL? Example 44002. See here, salary I created. Oh, okay. Rent also created? No, this is different company code. GM10. And 44000. See here I created a why. See here, for this company code and for this chart of accounts, I created two expenses, admin expenses and salary account expenses. Same way you need to create rent also in this company code. Okay, first enter your company code, then enter number range 44002. Okay, then click on your create. So this rent comes under indirect expenses. Then this rent comes under which which department? Functional area means department, finance department. And is this profit and loss account or balance sheet? Which one? It is comes under profit and loss account. Okay, then write it here description. Rent account. Okay, then click on your control data. And go down line item display, short key 001. See here, okay, you just concentrate here. What is this? Open item management. You just catch the point. At the time of rent payable GL creation, or at the time of commission receivable GL creation, you need to activate open item management radio button or indicator. Otherwise you don't activate. Not only rent to payable and not only commission receivable, all the payable GLs, all the receivable GLs comes under open item management. Okay, so I'm creating rent, not rent to payable. So line, don't activate this radio button. Then click on your create bank interest tab, G001, and click on your save. So I already explained what is mean by field status group, what is mean by short key, what is mean by line item data. Everything I explained. That is the reason I'm going fast. The next one. So this one is completed. Next one, rent payable. I need to create rent payable GL. So go to SAP, take here 16001 and enter your company code, then click on here create. Select here example current liability. This liability means comes under balance sheet. Enter your rent payable account and rent payable account. Then click on your control data and click on your only balance in local currency. Go down. Everyone, here you need to listen careful. What is meant by open item? Only balance in local currency. See, for example, in the theoretically, if you post any accounting entry, three types of currencies will be reflected. What is that? One is local currency, one is group currency, one is transactional currency. Okay, what is meant by only balance in local currency means whatever GLs you activate only balance in local currency, that GL value updated only local currency, that GL value that GL value not updated on group currency and transactional currency. Okay, it will be updated only local currency if you activate this radio button. Otherwise, that is optional. Example, at the time of discount GL creation, you need to activate this. At the time of GRIR clearing account creation, you need to activate this, like that. Okay, what is meant by only balance in local currency? Only balance in local currency means if you activate this radio button, whatever GL, I mean whatever GLs you can activate this only balance in local currency, that GL updated only local currency. It cannot update group currency or if you, any other currencies. Okay, then now not required, no problem. So this one, what is this? This is rent payable. That is the reason you need to activate open item management and line item display. Example, short key 001. Then click on your create bank interest tab. Open item management. Today is our topic is open item management. And click on your create bank interest tab. G001. Then press enter and save. Okay, then this one also completed. Sorry, do one thing. So what is the rent number range? 44 0003, right?
Yeah.
And rent payable means 16 0010. Rent means 44 0003. Rent payable means 16 0010. So here also comes under 16 0010. Cash already created. What is the number range? 22 0000. I mean the last class I created. What is that? See here, cash account 22 000. Yeah, and now I need to create commission receivable. Commission receivable comes under current asset. So what is the, what is the number range for current asset? I created number range, right? Go to OBD4. Go to OBD4 T code. What is the T code? OBD4. Then click on your position. What is our chart of accounts, John?
GMOC.
Very good. Enter here GMOC. What is current asset? See here, current assets 25 0002, 25 9999. This is the number range I created. Accounts groups. T code OBD4. Okay. And I want to create commission receivable. Go to FS00. What is the T code? FS00 for creation of GLs. Press enter. So here, like 25 0000. Then enter company code. Then click on your create. Accounts group comes under current asset and it is the balance sheet. Current asset is the balance sheet. Write the description. Commission receivable account and commission receivable account. See here, this is the number and this is the company code. This is comes under current asset. This current asset comes under balance sheet. This is commission receivable description. Then click on your control data. Then go down. This is click on your open item management. You just keep it on your mind. At the time of receivable GL creation, at the time of payable GL creation, you must activate open item management radio button. Why? Because all the payable GLs and all the receivable GLs cleared in the future. Cleared in the future. That is the reason you need to activate open item management. Very simple. Then click on your line item display, short key 001, and create bank interest tab G001. Press enter and save. Okay. Then the one more GL I need to create. So what is the number? 250000. And I need to create commission received. I need to create commission received. This is receivable and this is received. Okay. And what is the number range it will come? This is comes under indirect income. This is comes under income. And if I create last class any commission received? No, right? No. So what is the number range? What is the number range for indirect income? So this meeting will close down within 1 minute. You people joined again. So we will start to create commission received. Okay.
Okay.
Yes, everyone. Yes. Okay. Are you able to hear my voice?
Yes.
Yeah. So now this one is completed. Now I need to create commission received. This commission received comes under indirect income or other incomes. So what is the number range for indirect income? So how to find out that number range? Very simple. For your understanding purpose, I'm going to, what is the T code for find out the T code? I mean number range. OBD4, go to OBD4, press enter, then click on your position, enter your chart of accounts. What is our chart of accounts? GMOC, press enter. Let's search, where is that other income? See here, other incomes. What is the number range? 3200002, 3299999. So click on your new session, open the new session, and enter here FS00, enter. What is the number range? 3200000, right? Three two double zero double zero two, 3299999. In between, you can select any number. Example, I selected 3200000. Then this is the company code. Then click on your create. Then select here other incomes. Where is that? Select here other income. Is this profit and loss account or balance sheet? I'm asking the question.
P&L account.
Yes, very good. This is comes under profit and loss account, P&L account. And write the description. Commission received, not receivable. Commission received account. Commission received account. then click on your control data, then go down. At the time of commission received, don't activate open item management. When you want to create commission receivable, you need to activate open item management. Okay, and line item display, short key 001, and click on your create bank interest tab, G001, then press enter, radio button, then click on your save. Yeah, done. 320000. So what is the cash? GL 220000. Commission receivable. This is the one. Commission receivable. 250000. Yeah. Now our task is how to post this accounting entries. How to post this accounting entries. Everyone, listen carefully. If I want to post rent account data to rent payable, you can post T code FB50 or F-02. You can use both T code. Either you can use FB50 or F-02. See, yesterday, last class we discussed general document posting single screen FB50. GL document posting double screen F-02. You can use any T code, maybe FB50 or maybe F-02. Okay. If I want to post rent account data to rent payable, you can post FB50 or F-02. As your convenience, you can use any T code. And if you want to post rent payable account data to cash, which T code I need to use? F-06. What is the T code? F-06. Okay, what is meant by F-06? See here. GL incoming payment, F-06. GL incoming payment, F-06. Yeah. And FB50, F-06. Then next, I want to post commission receivable account data to commission received. Where I need to post this accounting entry? This accounting entry you want to post FB50 or F-02. Based on your convenience, you can post anywhere, no problem. Anywhere means FB50 or F-02. Then cash account data to commission receivable. Where I want to post this accounting entry? This accounting entry you want to post F-07. What is meant by 07? See here, 07 means what? GL outgoing payment. Everyone, listen careful and see this one. Now I am posting rent account data to rent payable. So which rent account data to rent payable? What is the T code for posting rent account data to rent payable? FB50 or F-02. You can use any T code. I am using FB50 T code. Everyone, slash and go back, use FB50, press enter button in the keyboard. Enter document date and posting date. For your convenience, I am taking both date are same, document date, posting date. I explained what is meant by document date and what is meant by posting date last class. Then here GL postings, then go down. What is this? GL number range. How the accounting entry will come? Rent account data to rent payable. What is the rent GL? 44003. You can take it here. And the rent payable 160010. You can take it here. 16001. Then this is an debit and this is an credit. How much amount? 10,000. Example 10,000. And here also 10,000. Then if you want to write narration, you can write it here. Then as usual, business area. Then as usual, profit center. Then segment pick automatically. Then press enter. What is the number range for what is the number for rent?
40002.
One second. Yeah, what is the rent? Very good, Harish. 44002, not for 3. 2 here. Okay, very good. You just take it 2 here. You can change 2. Here, rent. 44002. Press enter. Here, then click on your simulate. Rent account data to rent payable. 40 means debit, 50 means credit. Then click on your save. And go to document, click on your display. See here, and other ledgers. This is the different ledger, 0L, G1, G2, and other currencies. Different currencies, document currency, local currency and group currency, like that. And everyone, you please note it down, one T code, please note it down. GL, open item and cleared item report. GL open item and cleared item report. The T code FBL3N. FBL3N. The T code is FBL3N. Means I posted rent account data to rent payable, right? I want to see open item balance. Is this 10,000, 20,000, 40,000? How much is there? Okay, I want to see the report. Okay, see here. Everyone catch the point. FBL3N. Go to FBL3N, press enter. Enter your GL number. What is the GL number? Example 160010. Then enter your company code. What is this? Open item. In the SAP, everyone catch the point. In the SAP terminology, we are called as a open items. In the non-SAP, we are called as a outstanding balance. When you joined in the real-time environment, don't called outstanding balance. You need to call as a open items. Open item means outstanding balance. Okay, so select your open items, then click on your execute. How much open item balance is there? 10,000. This is the document number. This is the business area. This is the document type, date, everything will show in here. Okay. Then later. Then how to post rent payable account data to cash. Which GL I need to use? F-06. 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 Press enter. As usual, document date, posting date, as usual. Document date.
F-07, no, sir. I think.
06. Incoming payment.
This is for incoming payments.
Incoming payment.
Incoming.
Incoming payment, use 06.
Yeah.
So, document date and document type SCA and company code and month, then currency, then GL payment. See here, everyone, you just catch the point here. Bank data and open item selections. Bank data means here you need to select cash GL or bank GL. Cash GL or bank GL. Okay, everyone, listen. Sorry, I'm saying very sorry. Rent account data to rent payable and rent payable account data to cash. This is outgoing payment, right? Not incoming payment. And this is incoming payment. Very good, Arish. This is incoming payment. See everyone, when I post rent account data to cash, this is cash coming or going? It's a going, it's a credit. So here you can use F-07. Very good, Arish, very good. And here you can use F-06. Rent account data to rent payable and rent payable account data to cash. This is outgoing payment. You can use F-07. Sorry, it's my bad. Okay. And commission receivable account data to commission received. Then cash account data to commission receivable. Okay. This is incoming payment. You can use F-06. It's my bad. Very good, Ash. Very good. Yeah. So where I want to post rent payable account data to cash, you can use for F-07. Slash and enter your F-07. Press enter. Then as usual, document date, posting date, document type SCA. Document type SCA, company code, and posting date, month, currency, then GL payment. Payment means it may be receivable or it may be payable. If you want to write any narration, you can write it, everyone. Now you just catch the point. Bank data means here you need to select, it may be cash GL or it may be bank GL. John, are you able to understand, everyone?
Yes, it's very clear. Cash or bank GL.
Yeah, here you need to select cash or bank GL. Then open item means here you need to select any payable GL, rent payable, commission payable, okay, any payable. Okay, open item means here you need to select any payable. Okay, so cash 22000, example amount is 10,000. Then here, what is the open item? Open item GL 16000010. See here the cash, here rent payable. Then click on here, process open items. Process of very simple, document date, posting date, and document type, month, and company code, currency, reference. Here you need to select cash or bank GL, then amount, then here you need to select for open item, rent payable, any payable GL you need to select here. Then click on your process open items, then click on your simulate, go to document. Or everyone, you need to write one question, tomorrow you can search. What is the difference between partial payment and residual payment? You can write the question tomorrow. You can search and you can tell me tomorrow what is the difference between partial payment and residual payments. Okay, then click on your post. Go to document, click on your display. See here, rent payable account data to cash, 40 means debit, 50 means credit. Rent payable account data to cash, slash and go back. Once again, you can check this report, FBL 3N. Everyone, you just catch the point here, FBL 3N, press enter. Then enter your GL account, company code. Now you can select open item and click on your execute. There is a no balance. See here, no item selected in the open item. Why? Because all are cleared. So select here cleared, then click on your execute. See here, one is open item GL, one is cleared item GL. The outstanding balance is zero. Okay, rent payable is cleared. There is no outstanding balance. See here, when you selected your open item balance, displaying any open item means outstanding balances. This is the radio button for cleared, and this is for all. Maybe open item, maybe cleared. Both you can see here. When I click on your cleared all items, then execute, there is no open item balances, means there is no outstanding. Okay, now I want to post commission receivable account data to commission received. Commission receivable account data to commission received. What is the T code? FB50. Where I want to use FB50? Go to FB50, press enter. As usual, document date, currency, reference, GL posting, document type, then the GLs. What is the GLs? 250000 is the commission receivable. 320000 is the commission received. Debit and credit. How much? 20,000. Business area and profit center. Then press enter. Then click on your simulate. Then post. Go to document and display. See here, 40 means debit, 50 means credit. Commission receivable, count data to commission received. Slash n. And let's check FBL3N, FBL3N, enter, FBL3N, enter, and enter here 250000, 250000, and company code, select here open items, then execute. How much open item balance is there? 20,000. Okay, so this is the 20,000, right? How much I want to give? Cash account data to commission receivable, 20,000 20,000. Which T code I want to use? F-06. Obviously, document date, document type SCA, company code, posting date, currency, GL payment, here cash or bank. How much? 20,000. Here you need to select open items. It means any receivable GL. 250000. Then click on your process open item. Then click on your go to document and simulate. Then post. 40 means debit, 50 means credit. Cash account data to commission receivable. Then save. Do one thing. Let's go to FBL3N, enter. FBL3N, enter. Then commission receivable, company code. If you select open item, then click on your execute. There is a no outstanding balance, or there is no open item balance. Select your cleared item, then execute. See here, all the value cleared. Do one thing. I want to post one more accounting entry. Example, 50,000 and 50,000. Then here 20,000 and 20,000. Then $30,000 and $30,000. What is this? This is invoice posting. invoice posting, what is the T code? Example FB50 or F-02, both T codes, you can use any T code, no problem. Okay, what is that? Commission receivable account data to commission received. And this is the partial payment, 50,000 is there. First time I can pay 20,000, later I can pay 30,000. What is the T code here? F-06, incoming payment. Same to same, whatever T codes used, whatever process I can use, same to same you can post, but difference is two times. There is a 50,000. First you can pay 20,000, later you can pay 30,000. That's it. That is the difference. No. So where I want to post commission receivable account data to commission received, like go to FB50 fatafat, and document date, posting date. What is the accounting entry? Commission receivable account data to commission received. So 2500002 and 320000, then select here debit and credit, 50,000. For more understanding, I'm posting once again, you people catch the point here. Business area and profit center, press enter, then click on your simulate. See here, debit means and credit means. Debit means 40, credit means 50. Commission receivable account data to commission received. Then click on your post. Go to document and display. Check FBL3N. What is the T code? FBL3N. GL number and company code, open item. Click on your execute. See, 50,000 is the open item. And see here. Now you can post payment. First 20,000, later 30,000. Same process. F-06 and F-06. Document date. Document type SCA, bank 220000, amount 20,000, 250000. Click on your process open item. What is this? Partial payment. Select here partial payment. If you want to select full payment, select here standard. If you want to pay partial payment, select your partial payment. Tomorrow you want to search what is the difference between partial payment and residual payments. So select your partial payment and double click on here. Payment amount, you just double click on here. See here, this is my invoice value and this is my payment value. Total invoice value is 50,000. But I am paying only 20,000. Paying means it may be received or it may be paying. My payment is 20,000. Then click on here save. Go to document and display. And now you can understand properly. See here. Go to FBL3N. Enter. Enter your document date and GL number and company code, open item. John?
Yeah.
So if I select your open item and click on execute, how much balance is there?
30,000.
Very good. Click on your execute. See here, 30,000 open item balance is there. Got it, my point? What is the 30,000 is there? Then go back. Then go back. Do one thing. One more. Do one more payment. And F-06. F-06. I am posting one more payment. SA. How much spending? 30,000, right? I am posting 30,000. 30,000 is a final settlement, full payment. Then click on your process open item. 30,000 is the final payment and full payment. Okay. Then click on your standard means full payment. This is the 50,000 is the invoice value. And this 20,000 is the my last payment value. And this 30,000 is the my final payment value. Okay. 50,000 is the invoice. 20,000 and 30,000 is the payments. Final payment, full and final settlement. If you do full and final settlement, select your standard. And if you do partial payment, select your partial. You want to say what is meant by residual and partial tomorrow. Okay, then click on your save and post. FBL 3N, enter. Select your GL account, company code. If I select open item, how much balance is there?
Zero,
right?
Zero.
Select your open zero. Item, click on your execute. Zero, no balance, no item selected. Then select your cleared item. All are cleared. Zero. All are cleared. All the items comes under GL. See here, 20,000 and 20,000. Then 50,000, 20,000 and 30,000. All are cleared. Yeah, see here. You people note it down. I will tell you one thing. Concentrate here. If you want to post commission receivable account data to commission received, FB50 or F.02, and cash account data to commission receivable. Everyone, please catch the point here. I'm very, very important one. If you want to post commission receivable account data to commission received and FB50 or F-02, cash account data to commission receivable, which T code? F-06. But my concern is I want to post I want to post cash account data to commission received. I want to post this accounting entry directly. Example 15,000 and 15,000. Which T code I want to use? Everyone, are you
07, sir? F-06, sir.
F-07.
F-06.
No. No.
FB50 also possible, sir.
Very good. If you use key code FB50 or F-02, if I want to post cash account data to commission received, either you can use FB50 or F-02. If you go to F-06 for your understanding, if you go to F-06, press enter. Here I need to select cash or bank GL, and here I need to select open item. It may be, receivable, commission receivable GL I need to select here. But there is a no commission receivable here. Cash account data to commission received. This is not receivable. So here you need to select your commission receivable. This is not receivable. This is received. Okay, that is the reason you can use FB50 or F-02. Once again, this meeting will close 1 minute. If you joined again, I will explain you. Everyone, you just acquire the point here. If I want to post commission receivable account data to commission received, I can post FB50 or F-02. Okay. And if I want to post cash account data to commission received, commission receivable, this is the bull, receivable, not received, receivable. If I want to post cash account data to commission receivable, I can use F-06. But now my requirement is I want to post cash account data to commission received, not receivable. This is the received. Okay. For this purpose, you can use FB50 or F-02. In case if you use F-06, there is a no option to post commission received. See here I can select cash or bank GL. Here we need to select commission receivable, not received. Okay, so don't use F-06. You can use FB50 or F-02. Whatever T codes you can use, no problem. For your understanding, FB50, enter. Rajkumar, are you there?
Yeah,
are you understand what I'm saying?
I understand.
Yeah, and as usual, document date, currency, posting date, GL posting. Here, cash account data to commission received. Cash is 22000. Cash. Commission received 32000. Commission received. Then this is the debit and this is the credit. How much? 15,000 and 15,000 and business area and profit center. Segment will pick automatically. Press enter, then click on your simulate, then post. Go to document, then click on your display, 40 and 50. Okay, do one thing. My question is, this 15,000 is a open item or cleared item? My question to Vishnu. Vishnu, are you there? So I posted one accounting entry, right?
Yeah.
cash account data to commission received. Is this open item or cleared item?
It's a cleared item.
It's a cleared item.
Cleared item.
Yes, sorry, someone is speaking. It is a cleared item. This is not open item. Okay, let's check. Slash and go back. Let's check FBL 3N. Enter. Enter here. For example, example 250000. What is this? What is this GL number? Commission receivable GL number. Commission receivable GL number. There is a no receivable cash account data to commission paid. Sorry, commission received. There is a no receivable. Receivable is this concept, not here. Okay. This 15,000 is 320000. Then click on, when I select your open item, then click on your execute. Cleared item, then execute. Oh, still it is an open item. See, open item means it is showing a red symbol. Okay. I will tell you why it is showing the open item still. Means this is the cleared item. Okay. This is an a cleared item. This is not open item. But still it is an open item balance. Why it is, I will tell you later. Okay. Almost time is done. And this is an a 15,000 is an a cleared item, not our open item. Okay. Why it is an open item balance, I will tell you later. Okay. Then when I select here 250000, then click on your execute 250000, then click on select your open item, then click on your execute. There is a no open item. All are cleared. Commission receivable. All are clear. Okay. There is no open item. And one more point I will add you. Commission receivable account data to commission received. Where I want to post FB50 or F-02. Cash account data to commission receivable. F-06. And if I want to post cash account data to commission received, you can use FB50 or F-06. Same way here. Same way here. If you want to post rent account data to rent payable, you can use FB50 or F-02. If you want to post rent payable account data to cash, F-07. But my concern is I want to post rent account data to cash. To cash. Which T code I want to use? FB50 or F-02. Okay. Once again, listen careful. If I want to post rent account data to rent payable, which T code? FB50 or F-02. If I want to post rent payable account data to cash, F-07. If you want to post rent account data to cash directly, example 12,000 and 12,000. Which T code I want to use? FB50 or F-02. Okay. So this is like open item management. Okay. Any doubts? Anyone? Anyone? All the people?
No, sir.
Sunil, Sunil, Anji. You people are so silent. Any doubts? Clear, right? Thank you.